Welcome to the video news of the week. Vermont Governor Phil Scott and members of his cabinet visited various locations in Essex County on Tuesday as part of their Capital for a Day initiative. This is the 11th Capital for a Day where Scott and his cabinet members tour Vermont locations and visit with businesses and institutions in each area, covering the 14 counties of Vermont. On Tuesday, the tour took them to the Building Trades program at Canaan Schools, where Scott was shown around a structure that the Building Trades students have been rehabilitating.
A lot of times we expect people to come to Montpelier to voice their concerns or challenges and tell us about their opportunities. But then I thought, you know, people are busy and they're out in different parts of the state. And I thought we should go see them. And so we did this Capital for a Day. So this is the 11th Capital for a Day, 11th county that we've visited thus far. And I bring the entire cabinet with me. And then we split up during the day. We have our cabinet meeting in the morning. And then we split up and I, intertwine with cabinet members throughout the day. And we really do. We just look for what are the opportunities? What do we do really well? What could we use some help with? And it's been incredibly powerful for us as a cabinet, as a team, but also for the communities as well. You know, I'm a product of trades training. I went to Spalding High School, did my vocational training in the afternoons, did my college prep in the mornings, went to UVM to be a tech ed teacher, and received my certification, and decided not to teach at that point. Went into the construction trades myself, so co-owned a business for 30 years. So when I see this, I see all kinds of opportunity. They're doing it right, real hands-on life experience, showing up for work. I think is powerful, and I my hat's off to those, Mr. Reed and others who are behind this program, because it's essential, and I think we should replicate this throughout the state.
A water main break on Route 26 in Colebrook flooded this week, causing substantial damage to Colebrook Carpet Center, the decades-old business is owned by Donald Cotnor, who was called in on Monday morning to find around 600,000 gallons of water that had pushed its way through the foundation and floor. Cotnor found about 18 inches of water in a store when he arrived. Town crews shut off the main and slowed the water flow, but it took until Monday night before work was completed. Cotnor theorized frost had affected the water main pipe. Significant damage was found to the Colebrook Carpet Center stock and shelving, and over the next week, the business will move into the vacant building next to Citizens Bank in Colebrook. While discouraged, Cotnor said that he is thankful for the outpouring of support he received from the community.
Colebrook's new music store, Big Dog Music, held an official grand opening on Saturday. Area performers were on hand throughout the day as folks came in and toured the business. In addition to instruments, equipment, and accessories for sale, the shop also offers instrument repair and music lessons to those interested.
Looks like nothing's gonna change.
Regional musicians Comfort Country performed at the Trinity United Methodist Church at midday on Saturday. The group brought a selection of classic gospel and bluegrass tunes, as well as some original numbers by the band.
When I was young and in my prime, I
A concert was held at the Monadnock Congregational Church in Colebrook on Sunday afternoon. The event was arranged by local performers, and funds raised went towards a new wheelchair lift to be purchased for the church.
Once upon a time, you turned my wine back into water. And I have seen the wonders that no more can explain.
That's a ragged old fight that hit me on it. He said, have a seat. And I sat down. He said, you've been to this, been here. Have you been to this little town before? I said, no, I guess not.
I believe that somewhere in the darkest night, a candle glows. I believe for everyone who goes astray, someone will come to show the way.
On Thursday morning at 1:30 a.m., a call came into the Sherbrooke Fire Service reporting a blaze in Lennoxville at the John Deere dealership. Fire crews from all over Sherbrooke were rolling quickly to the scene, where they found the building showing flames and dark smoke. Firefighters battled the blaze until around 5 a.m., when the flames were finally mostly out. The fire was dangerous for the crews because of many explosive materials in the dealership. The building and its contents are a total loss valued at $3 million. There were no injuries. The Colebrook Chronicle Video News of the Week is sponsored by LaPerle's IGA of Colebrook. Great deals and instant coupons can be found on their website at laperlesiga.com. Murphy's Steakhouse at Bear Tree in Pittsburgh. Enjoy casual fine dining, a cozy atmosphere, and wonderful food. Try the chef's table on Sunday evenings. And by Woodsville Guaranty Savings Bank. Friendly local people, friendly local bank. And open 7 days a week inside Lancaster Shaw's. Friday's weather brings a high of 11 degrees with a low of -3. Saturday turns to snow with a high of 19, and Sunday warms up with a high of 25 and a low of 16. Colebrook and Gorham students went head-to-head in varsity basketball this past week, with Colebrook taking wins in both the boys' and girls' games. Thank you for watching the Video News of the Week.